was born in Yorkshire, but then we moved and lived in Norfolk for however many years. I've been living in Norfolk for a long time now. And then I was bored at school actually, and I just started playing guitar when I was 12. I just found something that, like, I think everyone was getting into their niche. Like, some people are great at math and, like, in top classes and all. Like, I wanted to be great at art, but I really can't, like, you know, stick figures is as far as I can go with quality drawing. But I found guitar. Like, guitar was always played in the background. Like, you know, my dad played guitar when I was growing up and he would, you know, plink away. But actually a teacher started teaching at school and I just fell in love with it then. And I think what was great about him as a teacher is that he let me learn anything I wanted to learn. You know, I never learned any scales or any theory of music at all. I'd say, I really want to learn this song. And I think the first song I learned was the James Bond theme tune. And it, like, it just obscure songs at first. And it was such a nice way to learn, because nothing was ever forced upon me to say, well, you know, run through this scale a bajillion times and nail it, then we'll move on or something. And so I actually, like, I was a massive fan of Hendrix when I first played guitar. Like, he was my guitar god. Like, I wanted to learn every Hendrix solo and, you know, just be Hendrix. And I think at a school show, I did a guitar solo behind the back of my head and tried to steal any Hendrix stage show, like, tricks and things. And he really turned me on to playing guitar. I mean, the creativity was just phenomenal. But having a teacher to say, you know, I mean, Steve Holmes, he was fantastic and he still teaches now. And to have him just say, all right, let's go for that song. And he would do a little cassette and of little guitar solos and give me some tab for it. And I could learn from the cassette. And I think I enjoyed that. Like, I enjoyed the credit of just, oh, I can play this song now. Like, you know, I like Hey Joe, so I can play the chords. And, you know, I think everyone learns to play Hey Joe and everyone gets sick of it by the end of it. But I think it was the first proper Hendrix song I learned as well. And it was nice to have that ability to just, you know, learn what I wanted to. There was nothing forced upon me.
Hello, and welcome to a very special Guitar Interactive Issue 20. It was 30 years ago that Stevie Ray Vaughan released Texas Flood, the album that breathed new life into the blues and made Stevie Ray Vaughan a household name. We're celebrating that milestone with this special Stevie Ray Vaughan issue. Inside, Jamie Humphries delivers a tech session on how to capture Stevie Ray Vaughan's Texas blues style. Phil Harris treats us to a look at Stevie Ray Vaughan's vintage Fenders, and Michael Caswell shows us how to get the Stevie Ray Vaughan sound with affordable, modern gear that anyone can aspire to. If your tastes are more towards jazz, check out our interview with the legendary Al Di Meola. We caught up with Al at London's Ronnie Scott's Club, where he was performing his new Abbey Road-recorded album of Beatles songs. Finally, it's back to the blues with up-and-coming British guitarist Oli Brown. Oli is fast cementing his reputation as Britain's hottest young bluesman, and we're proud to bring you not just an interview with him, but exclusive lessons too. This issue's amazing free entry competition prize is a stunning Schecter Blackjack 8-string guitar. Here's your chance to find out what all the extended guitar commotion is about with one of the finest 8-strings on the market. The lucky winner will also receive 6 free packs of Roto Sound's new 8-string sets, also reviewed in this issue. We said this was a special issue, and it is. Guitar Interactive is expanding once again by adding a brand new series on home recording, aimed at the practical guitarist. Check out Making Tracks inside. If you ever thought recording and recording gear was just too complicated and technical to be interesting, we're out to prove you wrong. Back to guitars, and our reviews include a world-exclusive first look at the new Roto Sound vintage but new FX pedals, fresh from the Summer NAMM show. We've got guitars from Vigier, G&L, Schecter, Godin, and Dan Electro. Pickups from EMG, an EVH 5150 combo, and more FX from Tech 21 and Chord. Meanwhile, it's a luxury time in the quiet room, with a fabulous Santa Cruz and a stunning Larrabee, an affordable new all-solid Hohner, and a brand new electroacoustic amp from an Italian maker we predict big things for. All this plus our regular tuition columns with downloadable tab and a great free software offer. Only in Guitar Interactive, the first interactive magazine for guitarists the world over, getting bigger and better all the time.